Welcome everybody to this webinar about hybrid low-code secret sauce, and we will cover that topic and I will tell you what our secret sauce is. My name is Jurgen Rentink. I've been working at Lanza for a long time, almost 20 years now, and in all those years at Lanza, I had a lot of roles. Currently I'm acting as solution architect and sales engineer, but I also was programmer, teacher, consultant, you name it. I did it at Lanza, and currently I'm also involved in some large projects involved where we are developing PWAs for mobile devices. One of the things that amazes me in all the years I was at Lanza is that we always found a way to make our product relevant for the market. And with that, I mean that we always try to go with trends in IT, not hypes, but we do follow trends, like we do these days with progressive web apps, for example. And I think that's pretty special, because Lanza is existing for a long time. The platform exists for a long time, but still we make modern applications. I also think it's very special, from what I saw in those last 20 years I worked for Lanza, that we always had a mixture of people that used our products. For example, we had a lot of RPG programmers from the IBMI that started using the platform and started using Visual Lanza, but we also had .NET developers that are very OO orientated, some very experienced, some not. But all of these types of developers, they were all able to be productive in the Visual Lanza platform, and they actually still are. We still have a lot of customers that are with us for years and years, and they still develop new functionality in the platform, or also reuse functionality that they already have built maybe 10 years ago in those new solutions that they develop with our platform. So our platform has evolved in all those years, and there's one thing that is really allowed us to implement those new technologies and enable developers with different backgrounds to quickly get productive with our platform. And that is a constant factor in our Visual Lanza environment, and that's called RDMLX, and that is actually our secret sauce. I will get back into what RDMLX is later in this webinar, but first I would like to cover a little bit more about what a hybrid low-code platform is. So these days, if you want to develop a solution, you have a really very broad spectrum of tools and platforms that you can use. Of course, we have a whole bunch of open source tools that can be utilized to build your solution. I think the big downside to that approach is that it's very hard to find developers that that can develop front-end, back-end, and middleware stuff with open source tools. They're pretty hard to find. But, and also, you need to have all those skill sets in your development team. So you need somebody who knows front-end, back-end. And while the tool may be free, because it's open source, it will take you much more time to develop the solution and also to maintain that solution. If you are at the end, have a cheaper way of building your solution, I'm not sure. So you can also choose a much more structured way to develop apps or solutions, and that is by choosing a no-code or low-code platform. These platforms, of course, help developers to develop apps much faster in a more consistent methodology. And the big advantage of that is that they're also much easier and cheaper to maintain. If we look at no-code and low-code platforms, they are all focused on creating your solution in a visible way by using drag and drop wizards, templates. They actually aim at making sure that you do not need to write any handwritten code. No code focuses completely on not handwriting code. I personally think that that is just too good to be true. I don't think you can build a serious business application without writing a single line of code, because you always have custom rules or things that are not possible to only create in a visual way. Traditional low-code tools, they actually get rid of that issue by making sure that you can also do some customization within their platform. But it's not actually within their platform, of course, but a traditional low-code platform allows you to do handwriting, and it's more extensible. Another variant is hybrid low-code, and hybrid low-code that actually combines all the aspects of a traditional low-code platform, so you can do visual things, and it combines it with traditional development, so the strength and flexibility of traditional hand coding development. And this approach actually can enable you to build applications 10 times, up to 10 times faster compared to traditional coding. So if we look at this small matrix that we currently have on the screen, there we see that no-code tools are really aiming for non-developers or citizen developers. And they actually are not very extendable, those platforms. We see the traditional low-code platforms that are extendable with coding, but as I mentioned a little bit before, you really need to have a knowledge of a second language to extend these platforms. For example, if you do backend stuff, you probably need Java or C Sharp or C to be able to extend a platform like that. And for the front end, you need HTML, JavaScript, maybe cascading style sheets or another front end framework, but you need to learn. And yeah, that's actually not the goal that we had when we wanted to make app development faster and more efficient, because we actually didn't want to rely on multiple skills or different technologies. We just wanted to have one technology to do it all. And that's where hybrid low code comes in place. With hybrid low code, it's also extendable, but it is extendable within the platform. So you don't need to have another skill to write a backend program that is a little bit different than a template will generate for you. You don't need JavaScript knowledge to create your own custom front end. That can all be done inside the hybrid low-code platform. And a thing that makes that all possible within the Visualanza hybrid low-code platform is RDMLX. And then, like I said, a bit later, we will really have a look at RDMLX and where it comes from. So with a hybrid low-code platform, you can build enterprise-level apps, regardless of the type of application or the size of the application. There's no limit in the platform for that. The platform can integrate basically with anything. The Visualanza platform has an integration module that allows you to, like I always say, it integrates with anything, with any technology and any transport mechanism. So whether it's SOAP services, email, RESTful APIs, everything is possible. But it will also integrate with legacy systems. So that's ensuring for you that you can use maybe that calculation module that you don't want to get rid of. You can still use that in the Visualanza platform. And as mentioned before, all customization that you do is inside the platform's IDE. You don't need to go out of the IDE. It's all inside front-end, back-end integration. It's all done with the same skill set. A hybrid low-code platform like Visualanza is also architecture independent. These days you hear a lot of noise about microservices and other distributed architectures. But sometimes a monolithic architecture can be more suitable for your solution. That, of course, depends on the type of solution you're looking for. With the Visual Answer platform, it's basically all possible to implement the architecture that you like. And like I always say, if you use a Visual Answer or a hybrid low-code platform like Visual Answer, every developer becomes a full-stack hero, and that hero can develop and maintain applications up to 10 times faster than he would with traditional development. So that's a big benefit. So now let's switch to what RDMLX is. So RDMLX, Rapid Development and Maintenance Language, it actually has been in Visual Answer since day one. It has always been in the product. RDMLX, the X stands for extended. So that means it's the second generation of the RDML language. But we still completely support the first generation because that is used and still used by some customers to create 50-50 applications on an IBMI machine. But during the time RDML evolved to RDMLX, it allows us to implement some more advanced techniques, like, for example, the new Visual Answer web applications, the RESTful APIs, and progressive web apps. And RDMLX also supports more data types, for example, in the database compared to RDML. Not a big difference between RDML and RDMLX is the RDMLX generation. Has become a little bit easier to understand for people that are familiar with more modern languages like C#, Pascal, or Java. We really should not compare the RDMLX language with those languages because RDMLX is much more high level and much easier to learn, but we made sure that developers with that background could understand some constructions in the code more easily than before. So why is this RDMLX so special? Well, I think it's very special because it allows us to create platform and database independent software that can be deployed to Windows, IBMI, and Linux. It is very easy to learn. It really doesn't take months to learn it. You can really be up and running in a few weeks. And of course, because of RDMLX, you never have to leave the Visual Answer platform. You can do anything inside the platform because of RDMLX. So let's start with that last benefit. I think we already touched this a little bit. If you compare a hybrid low-code platform with no-code or with traditional low-code platforms, you will see that a no-code platform is it's very hard and maybe even impossible to extend functionality. And in traditional low-code tools, you really need to have knowledge of an external tool or language to extend the platform. And like I said before, that's really not the goal that we have when we start using low-code tools to make sure that we can develop things faster, but also maintain things better and cheaper, and to make us less dependent of those technologies where people are hard to find and expensive. So with this hybrid low-code platform, you're able to do front-end, back-end integration, APIs, all in one platform with one skill set, and that's RDMLX. I will explain now shortly why RDMLX enables us to create platform-independent solutions. Everything that you generate in our platform, all the code behind it basically is RDMLX. So if we go to the left side of the screen, you see our platform. And if you build a solution in our platform and you build or compile it, actually the first step is that you build it. It will generate C code, JavaScript, HTML, maybe a cascading style sheet. And compilable objects will then be first deployed and then compiled on the target platform. So that will be done with a platform or with a compiler that is optimized for that particular platform. Because of that approach, you can imagine that if you build something and you deploy it to a Windows machine, it's actually the same flow as you want to deploy it to a Linux machine, because the only thing that's different is that the code is compiled on a Linux machine. So that ensures that we can do platform independent development, so to say. And in here in the Netherlands, where I am based in, we actually just finished the project, migrating somebody from the IBM i to a Windows environment. And yeah, that's actually just gone live, that project. So it's very easy to migrate those applications. By the way, on IBM i, we still also generate RPG if you use the RDML variant of our language, because for 50 to 50 screens, you need to use that variant. And basically the same technology can be used or is used to create database independency, because if you hook another database up to the platform, it will just generate the database tables in that other platform without the need to change something in the Visual Answer platform. Okay, having that said, that was one too many. Let's switch to our platform. So this is the Visual Answer platform. I'm going to show you how to very easily create a simple web application that can add a record to the to-dos database table. That database table is already here. If I open it up. And you see that the database table has some columns. For people who are not really familiar yet with the Visual Answer platform, in Visual Answer, everything is stored in a central repository, of course. So a column in the platform is not only a column, but it's also a field that can be used on screens. So all the metadata is stored, and you can actually define rules and triggers on field level or files level. You can create a visualization. So I can say, okay, if I want to use the description field, I want it to be a Google Material Design edit field, and I want it to look like an edit box, and I want it to be the default visualization. So every time I now use this field on a web page, it will look like this. So that's all stored in the metadata of the Visual Answer platform. Also on the file level, you can have indexes, rules and triggers, and that's all definable without writing a single line of code, of course, and you can add your business rules to this also. So the to-do app, we will start with a simple blank web page. We call it to-do web page. And we will start with a blank sheet. Of course, you can, in the platform, also use templates to generate this application. But I actually want to show you how easy it is to create, of course, a very simple application, but still an application from scratch in this framework. So we can say, okay, we want to have a layout on this screen. And we want to add some controls to that layout. You can search for that also. So I want to have a simple app bar, and this app bar needs to be on row one, it needs to be in column one, it needs to be center, it needs to fit in both, and it needs to extend three columns. And then of course, it needs to be a little bit smaller. Let's get that the guy a little bit up. So then to add a new to-do item, we need a description, and we basically need a button. So let's get this nice orange button over here. And of course, we want to make sure that that looks good on the screen. So we put it in row two, column two, top center, flow down, and we give it a little bit of top margin so it looks a little bit better. Okay. So we now already have a small form set up. Last thing we need to do is we need to have a list to be able to show the to-dos that we have. So we basically have the same procedure. We drag and drop a list component. And we say we want to fit it both. And we then need to do something with this list item because first of all, we need to bind it to a particular field, in this case, the to-do description. And in the team, we can say that we want it to look maybe a primary medium with a heading one style. So maybe if you are familiar with web development, then you see that these things really look like cascading style sheet elements or classes that you would use in your web page to give a particular item a particular look and feel. In the Visual Answer platform, you don't have separate style sheets. You just use the themes that you, we deliver a few themes in the product, but you can create your own themes, of course, also in here. So now we need to maybe also change this caption to add. And then we need to add some functionality when we click this button. So basically, there are two things that we want to do in this application. We want to create functionality to refresh the list. Oh, refresh. And we want to add functionality to insert a new item. And when we start the web page, so in the initialize event, so when the web page is started, we want to make sure that we refresh the list. And let me copy that statement. And if we click the button, we want to make sure that we call the insert method to make sure that we can insert a new item. And after that, we might want to refresh the list so we see the new created item. So this is only, of course, front end. So how can we make sure that the backend really understands what we need to do? Well, that's pretty easy because in Visual Answer platform, a backend component is called the server module. We have some variants of that. In this case, we need a server module that works together with an application. We call it, for example, to-do server. We say which file it needs to use. And I think the file name was to-dos. Yes. And we can say create. And this is, of course, the power of low code. What now happened is a complete CRUD backend module was generated for you with all the optionality to find, add, delete, and update a to-do item and to find more items. For example, if we find the find all, that will, of course, give us all the to-do items back. If we do an insert, then we see that it will insert a to-do item into the database. So all the code behind this generated module is RDMLX. And usually, I'm not sure if people are aware of how this works in open source or other environments. There you really need to take care of the communication between front-end and back-end. You need to maybe create some JSON structures that you need to send from front-end to back-end. With the Visual Answer platform, that's all taken care of. Because a backend module just has a simple interface. It has, in this case, a group that inputs something and it sets something back. If you want to know how this group looks like, you can just use functionality of the platform to press, in this case, F2 on your keyboard, and you will see that this group consists of two fields, and that are actually the database fields that we have. And if you double click it, you also go to the RDMLX definition. We will copy this because this interface is needed for us in the front end to be able to call the insert service that is created in this server module. Must not forget to compile the server module, of course. And if we now go here, then we can easily paste that group in here. So we now have a front end page, we have a backend module. Only thing we need to do now is to connect those two together. So we can tell this routine that we want to use, in this case, the to-do server, and we want to use the service find all. We can give this a name, say find all to-dos. And that's basically the only thing that you need to do to connect your front end to your back end. The front end now knows that if this routine is called, that we want to actually use the find all service. The only thing we have to do is tell this routine when we want to use this service. And we can actually use this service in two particular ways. We can use an execute that is real time, and we can use asynchronously so that we actually do not really wait for the response, but the application continues. In this case, I will just use the execute. Because it's an all integrated platform, the front end knows what the interface is of the back end modules. So we need to send a list, and yeah, basically there's no typing. It's just selecting things. And we basically can do the same thing for our insert routine. And we say, okay, we have this backend module where we want to use the insert service. And we can give it a name again. We say, okay, we want to call this insert to do. And the only thing we here have to do is say, okay, we want to actually execute that routine. And with a simple selection, in some tools, I think in Visual Studio, it's called IntelliSense or something, you can just select what you want to put in here, and you don't really have to think of that yourself. The platform helps you with it. So this is basically all that's needed to create a simple web page to add items to a particular database file. In this case, the to-do items, we can execute it and it will then load. And you see that already prepared some items in here. So this is a very simple example, but you see that in the Visual Lanza platform, a lot can be done by code generation and by templates and wizards, but everything that's behind it is actually this RDMLX. And you see that if you wanna break out of the templates and out of the wizards, it's pretty easy to create something from scratch in a web page, if you have a little bit of knowledge of RDMLX, because this is not really complex. This is pretty easy to learn and pretty easy to generate. One thing I wanted to show you in this demo also is, of course, the themes. That's always a nice thing to play around with. You see, if you choose the orange theme, then you see that the app bar gets another color and this gets another color. This illustrates that basically, the themes have the same power as cascading style sheets, where you can define your style and then apply it. Only in the platform, you can, of course, have multiple styles and play around with it as much as you want. So let's head back to this PowerPoint. So after seeing all this, you probably now think, okay, can I use this? Can I try this? Well, absolutely, you can register on the web page that's on the screen to download the trial version of the Visual Lanza platform. And if you register, some of my colleagues will contact you on how you can download it, how you can install it. And you probably also get some emails where you can find some links in it to understand how you can learn this platform, because we also have a Learn Lanza platform. That's an online platform where you can learn Visual Lanza at your own pace. So the one that's illustrated here is the Visual Lanza free trial experience. That's probably a good one to start with. But here on this platform, you can really learn our platform and the RDMLX language, and it will help you start up your first project. And then I hear you say, my first project, do I have to start that completely on my own? Absolutely not. We have a very good professional services team with a lot of bright people that can help you with your first project. You can basically do that any way you want it. You can have us completely do your first project. You can have us guide you through your first project. All possibilities are open with our professional services team. And once you started your first project, you might even want to join the developer.lanza.com website, where we have a Lanza forum, where we have a community, where you can communicate with other Lanza users to maybe find out things that are not maybe in one of the courses, or maybe you found something specific for your situation where you think, okay, how can I do that? And then you always have the Lanza forum where you can ask those questions. You can also read our blog posts here, and there are some tips and techniques that you can look at. So that's also a very good resource for you if you are working with the Visual Lanza platform. Okay, this concludes this webinar. If you want to have more information about the Visual Lanza platform, please contact us at the email address that's on the screen right now.